We should be careful when we choose between linear or logarithmic scale in order not to lose data. In this example, the sample analyzed show only 4 discerned elements on the linear scale, but at least 7 elements on the log scale. Had we chosen the linear scale, we would not have identified some peaks. When reading fluorescent emissions, we should be aware that some of the light from one fluorochrome will be read in the channel of another fluorochrome, thus giving us the false impression that some of the latter fluorochrome is present. Therefore, we must compensate the reading on the cytometer. We do that by telling the machine the percentage of light from one fluorochrome that is read as another fluorochrome. With more than a couple of fluorochromes being read at the same time, calibrating the readings in hand can be challenging. In modern cytometers, we can automate this process. First, by analyzing samples with only one fluorochrome at a time and adjusting the program to each negative and positive population. Once all the fluorochromes have been parameterized, we can run our sample with a mix of fluorochromes. We may still have to fine-tune individual parameters of the compensation matrix to get the best result. When doing a manual calibration, we can use markers of different fluorescence intensity. Choosing the right marker is crucial for the calibration. If the marker has too weak an emission, the positive population will be too close to the negative one, thus making small compensation difficult to see. If the marker has too strong an emission, we will tend to overcompensate, as we would have a natural tendency to try to align the two populations by the top. A middle level emission marker would suit us best.